So, welcome back. In this presentation, we are going to look into one of the more important topics of ecosystem, the study of food chain. After going through this presentation, we will get a basic idea as to what a food chain is. We will define what a food chain is. We will look into the types of food chain in ecosystems, and we will look into the study of the significance of food chain. Now let us start the entire issue with a very simple example. Say grass, it is being fed upon by grasshopper. Then we have frog feeding upon the grasshopper, a snake feeding upon the frog, and the hawk feeding upon the snake. So what is happening out here is that basically grasses, they are photosynthesizing and trapping the solar energy, which is being passed to other organisms in the ecosystem in a stepwise manner. And when the energy is being passed, along with the energy, nutrients are also being transferred from one organism to the other. Say for example, from the grass, nutrients are getting transferred to grasshopper, from the grasshopper to the frog, and so on. So how do we basically define a food chain? A food chain is a sequential interlinking of organisms involving the transfer of food and energy. Sequential interlinking, that is, they are linked in a sequence. Say a grasshopper, definitely maybe the snake would not take it outrightly. The frog will not directly feed upon the grass. So it all happens in a sequence. So sequential interlinking of organisms involving transfer of food and energy. Say the frog is getting food from the grasshopper when it is eating it, and it is also getting the energy from the producers through a series of organisms. So it all starts basically with the producers, and say the hawk, it is going to get its food through a series of other organisms. And in this process, what is happening is that there is repeated eating and being eaten. Say the grasshopper is eating upon the grass, it is being eaten upon by the frog. The frog is eating upon the grasshopper, it is being eaten upon by the snake, and so on. So such a process is known as a food chain. Now what are the essential features? In other words, we can say that the biotic factors of the ecosystem are linked together by food. Say one eats upon the other. The producers form the food of the for the herbivores, which in turn form the food for the carnivores. In the food chain that we just looked at, we started with the producers, and the grasshopper is the herbivore in this case, and the herbivore in turn is forming the food for the carnivores. A food chain shows one of the several possible pathways along which nutrients and energy can flow through an ecosystem. So it is not that if we have shown one food chain, that is the only way energy will flow through the ecosystem, because in an ecosystem, we have got many organisms which are interlinked with one another. So there will be many food chains operating simultaneously at the same time. In a food chain, there is a unidirectional flow of energy from the sun to producers and then to a series of consumers of various types. So we all know that there are two basic features in an ecosystem. One is the flow of energy, other is the biogeochemical cycle. Flow of energy is always unidirectional, that is, it flows from the sun, it comes to the grass. The grass cannot give back the energy to the sun. From the grass, it is going to the grasshopper. The grasshopper cannot give the energy back to the grass. That is why it is known as unidirectional flow of energy. And that is why the food chain is always straight and proceeds in a straight line. The length of the food chain is the number of links in it. How many links are there? The average length of the food chain in most cases is 4 to 5 links. In certain cases, up to 10 links have been reported, but such instances are very rare. Omnivores, they occupy more than one trophic level. Say organisms, such as human beings, we feed upon plants, we also feed upon animals, fine. So we are basically omnivores. So definitely if we want to put human beings in a food chain, we will fall at more than one trophic level. And some organisms occupy different trophic positions in different food chains. Not only that, say some organisms during different stages of the life history will occupy different trophic positions. Say for example, if we take the case of frog, the tadpole, it will form a part of a different food chain, and the frog itself will form a part of a different food chain. Now, types of food chain. Generally, two types of food chains are distinguished within an ecosystem: the grazing food chain and the detritus food chain. Grazing food chain, it is traditionally defined as a food chain in which the energy at the lowest trophic level is derived from photosynthesis. That is, the first trophic level, always the photosynthesis occurs. That is the traditional definition. And it basically is of two types: predator-prey or prey-predator food chain and the parasitic food chain. And then we have a very special case which is known as a food cycle. So what we are going to do is that first we are going to look into prey-predator food chain, then into parasitic food chain. After that, we will go into detritus food chain, and finally we will look into food cycle. Prey-predator food chain. This type of food chain depends upon autotrophic energy capture and further movement of the captured energy. That is the first example that we took. Here one animal captures and devours another animal. The animal which is being eaten is called the prey, and the animal which eats it is called the predator. The prey-predator food chain is formed of plants, herbivores, primary carnivores, secondary carnivores, and so on. Most of the ecosystems in nature follow this type of food chain. If we look into examples, say forest ecosystem, say green plant being fed upon by the deer, which is again being fed upon by tiger. Then if we look into desert ecosystem, we have shrub, and there's rat feeding on the shrub. And now this is a viper which is totally camouflaged in the sand of the desert. It feeds upon the rat. And then we have predatory birds which feed upon snakes. Parasitic food chain. The plants and animals of the grazing food chain are infected by parasites. When the smaller organisms, parasites, consume larger ones without outright killing of the host, the food chain is called parasitic food chain. So if you look into the prey-predator food chain, there, what is happening is that tiger is outrightly killing the deer. In the case of the parasitic food chain, there is no outright killing of the host. The food chain is characterized by parasites which live on or inside the body of the host and derive nutritional benefit from the host, in lieu of which the host is harmed. The food chain progressively passes from larger organisms to smaller ones without outright killing, as in the case of predator, that is what we have just mentioned. Say, only when the parasite load is very high in certain cases, the host may die. Otherwise, in general, the parasite is in no mood or does not kill the host. Examples, say plant roots being fed upon by or parasitized by nematode, and nematodes are parasitized by bacteria. Then we have dog, which is parasitized by flea, and this flea is parasitized by protozoa. So these are examples of parasitic food chain. Detritus food chain. The organic waste and dead matter derived from grazing food chain is generally termed as detritus. The energy contained in the detritus, it does not go waste, but it serves the source of energy for a group of organisms, detritivores, in the detritus food chain. This type of food chain goes from dead organic matter into microorganisms. Microorganisms, they degrade the dead organic matter, and then to organisms which feed on the detritus and their predators. So if we have detritus, and this is decomposed by bacteria and fungi. They are fed upon by worms and insects. They may be further fed upon by frogs and lizards, snakes, eagles and hawks, and so on. food cycle. A food cycle is a directed sequence of one or more trophic links starting and ending with the same species. That is, if it starts with one species and ends with the same species, that is known as a food cycle. So, cycle of length one, it is known as cannibalism. The cannibalism is quite common in animal kingdom. So, we have the example of sexual cannibalism, where in the praying mantis, the female, it kills and devours the male after mating. The same happens in case of many spiders, as well as in the case of scorpions. So, if one animal is feeding upon the same species, then the cycle is of length one. A cycle of length two means that A eats B and B eats A, that is wasps and spiders. Significance of the study of food chain. Food chain helps us in understanding the feeding relations and the interaction between organisms in an ecosystem. That is how the organisms are interacting with one another, the energy flow mechanism and the matter of and matter circulation in the ecosystem. That is, they also help us to understand how biogeochemical cycles manifest themselves. Then when we are talking of the food chain, definitely we understand how toxic substances get accumulated in the food chain and the problem of biological magnification manifests itself. Thank you very much. You may mail your feedback to raz.manideep@gmail.com.